guys, Realtor Mike here. To those new to my channel, I'm a real estate broker living and specializing in the Nuvali area. In this episode, I will share with you a brief and informal history of Nuvali, how it came about, kung why Nuvali is so big now, no? Meron siyang roots, meron siyang origin. So let's start. I dare say that the roots and origin of Nuvali right now is the Laguna Technopark. So Laguna Technopark, it is a world-class industrial zone. So it's like a very big village, 224 hectares, na ang composition niya light and medium, non-polluting / non-smoke emitting enterprises / factories, local and global companies. Yun yung inorganize ni Ayala Land under Ayala Land Logistics Holding Corporation. Again, partnership with Mitsubishi of Japan. I feel that, ito opinion ko lang, during the 1990s, yung Mitsubishi of Japan had the technical knowledge of ano mga ganyang technoparks. That's why Ayala Land partner with Mitsubishi, thus creating Laguna Technopark. Yun, that was in the 1990s, no? So as you can see, deeply master planned siya, no? Yun ang nauna na ginawa ni Ayala. So there are factories, there are workers, so there's the need for residential areas and commercial areas. So naging hub siya of convergence and economic activity. That is the integral part of the economic boom and progress of the Calabar Zone area. Ngayon nga, they're doing technoparks in Cavite, in Pampanga, and in Mindanao, replicating itong ano, itong what happened in Santa Rosa. But as you know, it encompasses Santa Rosa. Santa Rosa yan, Binyan, Tukabuyaw, to even Canlubang / Calamba, Laguna. Yon. So after that technopark, there was a need to develop the peripheries, no? Yung residential. So Ayala made, ano, no? Ayala established Laguna Properties Holdings. It's a 120-hectare residential component around Laguna Technopark, no? So doon nagsimula yung Santa Rosa Village, San Jose Village, Santa Rosa Estates, 2,500 units during the 1990s and moving towards the year 2000. And then 1998, ano naman yung high-end nila, Ayala West Group was born. And then in 2010, Nuvali was formed. Okay? So as we can see, yun yung seed na nagsimula nitong what is happening around the Santa Rosa area. In fact, yung Santa Rosa area, they call it the Tiger City of the South due to the numerous different parks. May mga ibang may ibang developers na who are riding on the boom of this area. May mga kanya-kanyang kanya-kanyang techno park around it na. May Carmel Ray, meron si Greenfield, and some other small techno parks also around the area. Yon. So doon nagsimula yon. So as you can see, si Ayala Land, hindi lang siya kukuha ng isang land, ng isang lupa, and then they'll put subdivision, then sell it. Meron siyang DNA, meron siyang long-term, may long-term plan siya about it. So nagsimula yon, 1990, 30 years ago. So it's not an overnight success. It was deliberately planned. The technopark, the small residential areas, and then the commercial areas, then West Grove, high-end residential villages, then commercial again, then Nuvali. So the hospitals, the hotels, the schools, so the major schools are here. Oh, nakita nila may population na kasi, meron ng mga end users. Unlike in some other developments, they just get a land, put up housing units and sell it. Wala namang supporting areas. As a comparison, no? Just a comparison in terms of what's happening in informal settlers, no? There are many informal settlers in Metro Manila, no? The relocation program of the government, which is not really successful. The informal settlers in Quezon City, they get a land in Bulacan, tapos doon nila dadalin. They'll give them land, they'll give them titles, they'll give them properties, pero walang livelihood, walang schools, walang facilities. So those people end up going back to where they came from, yung Metro Manila, yung Shanty. Kaya I think hindi good solution yun, no? It has to be a comprehensive thing. I'm sorry for the analogy, no, but that's the analogy that pops into my mind, no. So what they did here in Santa Rosa, kumpleto lahat because I started with livelihood, then commercial, residential school. So Ayala pretty much knows what they're doing. Yan. Kaya that's why they can demand a certain price level and price point for their properties. Many say mahal naman, but the previous investors of Ayala know that it will just go up because it's a comprehensive thing. It's not a flash in the pan. They have a long-term, ano, long-term horizon for the development. Just like yung, ano, yung track record in terms of real estate. Si Ayala Land is ano eh, is unmatchable eh, no? Price history of Forbes Park, Das Marinas Village, Bel Air, Ordaneta, Magallanes, Ayala Heights, Ayala Hillside, Ferndale Homes, Verdana Homes. Ano talaga eh, they may price it in the start na you think it's above market, pero over the long term, I haven't seen any village ng Ayala Land developed by Ayala Land na bumaba or mababa. These people who bought into it are the ones investing now. That's why sold out palagi. There's a line. There's a priority selling because their investments paid well in the past. That's why medyo madalas sold out ang ano the properties or the communities of Ayala Land, especially the ano the horizontal. Yan. So it's not a fully technical and complete dates of history of Nuvali, no? But more or less, I hope with that video, we can see kung saan ang galing yan. It's a long-term vision, 30 years. And it's going to last another 30, 40, even 100 years of prices going up because of the deep seed, the good foundation that developer has put into this area. Yan, okay. So I hope I provided value for this afternoon. So don't forget to click that subscribe button and feel free to share with your friends itong video and then my channel. Again, this is Realtor Mike saying stay safe and stay in faith. God bless you. Bye.